This video is sponsored by HubSpot.
Have you ever wondered how productive you could be if there were two of you? Well, in today's world where AI is taking off, this is actually almost possible. Not another human, but pretty close. What am I talking about? I'm talking about ChatGPT. In today's video, I'm going to share 5 hacks on how to use ChatGPT to be 2x more productive at your day job. Whether you're working as a software engineer or a program manager or a product manager or a data analyst, the tips that I'm going to be sharing here is relevant to everybody. So what is ChatGPT? ChatGPT is an AI bot and it talks to you like a human would do. And it's free for now. I actually did this video on ChatGPT on how I would learn any coding language fast using ChatGPT, so feel free to watch that.
AI space is just getting started and here to stay. Microsoft is already working on a big integration, and Google earlier in February announced their own version of ChatGPT called Bard, which they will be launching in the next few weeks.
Before we jump into the video, I do want to make sure that I have 2 disclaimers. One, everything I share in this video are my opinion and not of any of the companies that I currently work at or have worked at in the past. Second, whatever you do with ChatGPT, make sure that you don't compromise any of the intellectual work that you do at your day job. That means do not put your company's code on ChatGPT, because whatever you put in ChatGPT becomes part of the training model. So you don't want to get yourself in trouble. So just a quick disclaimer before I jump in and talk about ChatGPT. So hack number one, what you can do with ChatGPT to make yourself 2x more productive is use it to summarize meeting notes. So let's say you attended a meeting where you took meeting notes. Now you have to respond to all the attendees with the meeting notes and you need to polish them up and send the email. You can do that manually. It would take you probably 30 minutes or so. You can also do that with ChatGPT where it'd probably take you 2 minutes. So for example, here are some rough notes that I took and I want to ask ChatGPT to create a very nice email that I can just copy paste and send it to the stakeholders.
So here you can see that it has started spitting out very nice email that I can just basically copy paste it and put it in my email. It has the summary as well as next steps. This is typically how I write my meeting notes as well, so it looks great to me.
Hack number two is writing performance review. Most companies have some sort of performance review process where you have to give feedback on your peers, you have to write performance review on yourself, and it takes hours and hours of work to complete that. Believe me, I did that last month, and that was one of the weeks where I actually ended up working many more hours than normal. For example, here I am trying to summarize the impact of my work. I have some projects listed as bullet points here, but I want to write a very crisp summary from all these projects. So I input it here into the ChatGPT and I said, hey, can you create a performance review summary based on these bullet points and these projects and these impacts? And it created a beautiful summary for me. And let's say if you're giving a feedback on somebody, for example, I wanted to give feedback to John. John is not really my teammate, but he's a hypothetical person. So let's say if I'm giving feedback on John, I want to highlight John's strength is ambiguity and ownership. And their opportunities of areas is to deep dive. So here I would ask ChatGPT to write a peer feedback that I can use to save me time. I know this sounds actually too good to be true, but it actually is true. Like, it could save you hours of time to use ChatGPT for performance reviews because some of it is somewhat repetitive. Hack number three, you can actually, let's say if you do some repetitive tasks in Excel and you have a process around it where, for example, every week you create a report and in Excel you create some tables and then you copy paste those tables and send an email to stakeholders. So this could be like monthly sales or users or any reporting of that. Here you can actually use ChatGPT to have it write a VBA code to create macros for you. And using that VBA macro code, you will input it into your Excel and it will automatically copy paste that report and send it to relevant stakeholders. And basically you just automated your own job, which is amazing. And you can use actually the time that you were spending on the repetitive tasks where you were not learning a lot. Now you can use it somewhere else to be somewhere else, which is more productive than this. Number four, and I've talked about it in my previous one, you can have ChatGPT write new code. You can have it debug your existing code. You can also have it document your code. For example, this piece of code that I had, I wanted to add documentation around it. So I asked ChatGPT, could you add some comments and documentation around what this code does? So ChatGPT does a really, really wonderful job basically adding comments, and that's my documentation. And there is so much more that you can do with coding and ChatGPT, and I actually briefly covered it in this video where I talked about how to learn coding fast, and I talked about how you can use it to learn Python fast. So feel free to watch that video, but there is so much potential when it comes to coding with ChatGPT.
Let's do one more example using Python and data analysis techniques.
So let's say you want to write some Python code that will create data visualizations for your data. First thing I would do is figure out what type of visualization I want. I found this free Intro to Visualization ebook, which is basically a beginner guide to learning different types of visualizations out there, including bar plot, line chart, time series chart, pie chart, heat map. This guide is created by HubSpot, who is also sponsoring today's video. So let's say you're working through some time series data and you go through this guide and this chart line graph specifically stands out to you. So you know this is what you want, but you don't know how to create it using Python. So this is exactly where you would use ChatGPT to write a Python code for you.
Let's go to ChatGPT and write the prompt, create Python code to create line graph on daily sales data. So here it's generating the code. So once it has finished generating the code, what we're going to do is we're going to try this code. So what I'm going to copy paste this code, and I created a Google Collab notebook. So I'm going to paste it there and I'm going to hit play, and it's going to generate a plot for me. Ta-da.
So again, I'm using this guide to understand what are the different types of visualizations that I can use, but I'm getting help from ChatGPT to help me write that code in Python to create that visualization on my data set. If you're new to data analysis and like pretty visual, this Intro to Data Visualization ebook is a free resource. I'm linking the ebook below. You can download it, it's free. Now moving on to hack number five. Hack number five, you can actually use it as a research assistant. For example, if you're trying to do some market research and you're trying to understand a product area, or you're trying to understand specific concepts, whether those are like tech concepts or non-tech concepts, you can use ChatGPT to get more clarification on what a specific topic actually is. You can do it for researching several things. You can use it for like researching purposes and get more information out of it. I have personally used it for understanding new concepts. For example, in machine learning, there is a concept of classification modeling and linear regression. So I have been asking ChatGPT to specifically explain it, these two models, as you would explain it to a child. There is no shame in asking simple questions like that. And as I have seen that whenever I ask ChatGPT, can you explain it to a child? It gives me a very simple explanation of the topic and I'm able to absorb it and grab it. And it's very easy for me to understand as well. So use it as a research assistant to like search into different topics such as user research, or like I'm becoming financially literate. I'm trying to understand what is the difference between Roth IRA and 401k and things like that. So you can use it for any possible topic. Think of ChatGPT like a giant book. It has all the answers, but you just need to sift through those 1,000-page book to figure out what to search for. You need to sift through those 1,000 pages to basically get to an answer. But with ChatGPT, you're basically writing, asking it questions where it jumps to that page number 576, where it actually has the answer. So a couple of things to keep in mind, that there are specific limitations to using ChatGPT. The biggest one is that it has data from 2021 to present. That being said, there are limitations to using ChatGPT or any AI-based chatbot and AI assistant. The answers that you're gonna get are going to be super generic. So let's say if everybody's in your company is writing performance reviews using ChatGPT, then the chances are everybody's performance review is going to look similar, which is not really the purpose of giving peer feedback or reviewing. So be very mindful when you're using it. Validate what it's spitting out before you share it and make it part of your work. Let me know in the comments what are some creative ways that you have been using ChatGPT at your work or outside work or for your personal project. You can watch this video next where I talk about how to learn any coding language fast using ChatGPT. All right, with that, I hope you're having a great day. I will talk to you in the next video. Bye.